In this video, we are going to see how to heal insulin resistance permanently. So do you know what is the number one cause of insulin resistance? It is inflammation inside your body. Yes, insulin resistance is caused by inflammation inside your body. And why there is inflammation inside your body? First and foremost cause is your poor diet. So you are eating a lot of refined sugar, high fructose corn syrup, red meat, lot of unhealthy junk foods. So that triggers inflammation inside your body and can cause insulin resistance. Second important thing is stress. So if you are not getting enough good quality sleep, if you are tensed about something all the time, if you are not doing yoga, meditation, exercise, then it can trigger inflammation inside your body and can predispose you to insulin resistance. Then there is one thing, that is chronic state of calorie surplus. So most people do not have a control over the portion size. They eat too much and they are in fed state 24 hours. They do not practice fasting. So they do not heal their body, and that can cause inflammation and insulin resistance. Keep in mind that whenever you are eating any food, let it be healthy food, that triggers inflammation because it has to be digested, and as a result of digestion, byproducts are generated, certain metabolites are generated, and these metabolites can cause inflammation. They do cause inflammation, but the degree of inflammation is very negligible. But for someone who is suffering from insulin resistance and trying to heal, you want to do intermittent fasting so that you can accelerate the process of healing and decreasing inflammation. So I always advise you to practice intermittent fasting to heal your insulin resistance. Then the other important thing is lack of exposure to sunlight. So you are not getting enough vitamin D. So vitamin D is very important to bring down inflammation inside your body. If you are not getting enough vitamin D, your body will have increased inflammation. Your vitamin D receptors that are located in almost every cells of the body, they will not function properly. There will be increased inflammation inside your whole body. Then poor gut health. So most people do not eat good prebiotics or probiotics, and their gut health is very poor. And if you take a lot of antibiotics, prescription drugs, then also you are causing poor gut health. So this can result in inflammation and insulin resistance. So which organ is the most affected when you are having increased inflammation? It is your hypothalamus that controls the hunger. So hypothalamus, there is inflammation and there is imbalance. So most people lose control over their hunger. So they experience increased hunger because of increased inflammation of your hypothalamus. So most people will have increased hunger and they will keep on eating and eating and eating, and that can cause insulin resistance. And as a result of insulin resistance, again there will be increased hunger, and again there will be insulin resistance. So your pancreas will get exhausted over a period of time and it will terminate into type 2 diabetes. So this is how insulin resistance is caused. When there is increased inflammation, what happens that the receptors, the cells become insensitive to insulin. So these cells become insensitive to the action of insulin. So you have increased insulin inside the blood, but at the cellular level this insulin is not working properly because of increased inflammation. So your cells have become insensitive to the physiological function of insulin. So this is the cause of insulin resistance, inflammation. So how to correct it naturally? To correct it naturally, you have to follow anti-inflammatory protocol, anti-inflammatory diet, a diet which is very rich in antioxidants and which has anti-inflammatory effect on your body. So first and foremost, that you have to avoid refined sugar, refined carbs, processed food, junk food, deep fried foods. You have to avoid. You cannot expect to correct insulin resistance without avoiding these unhealthy foods. Then I also recommend you to avoid red meat, not only because it is very good, it is very very bad for your gut health. It is very high in iron. So iron is a pro-oxidant, and the last thing I would want you is to consume a pro-oxidant when you are already having increased inflammation. So avoid red meat. Then avoid palmitic acid. This causes increased inflammation in your hypothalamus. Vegetable oils. And for someone who is wanting to correct it naturally, should avoid gluten, another inflammatory agent. So the key is to eat a healthy, clean diet. So what is the diet that I recommend? Lot of vegetables, green leafy vegetables, lots, sweet potatoes, vegetables. Then fruits also. Yes, I do recommend fruits because fruits have flavonoids, these have polyphenols, and they exert anti-inflammatory effects. Fruits like pomegranate, pineapples, and in fact apples, they have quercetin, which is very potent anti-inflammatory agent. So you want to bring down inflammation by eating fruits. And of course, keep in mind portion size is equally important, so do not over consume. So you can make fruit salad daily and consume it by combining different foods like one apple, some pomegranate, some berries, then other types of citrus fruits are there. So you can consume fruits, but not overdo it. Then consume lean meat, fish and eggs. Again, moderate, do not overdo it. You want to consume fish for omega-3, which is a very potent against inflammation. So consume lean meat for high quality protein. Eggs, again, not more than 2 per day for high quality protein. Fish for omega-3, again, good quality protein. Then also consume brown rice. So this is good for fibers, and fibers are needed for good gut health. They are very important prebiotics. So to improve the functioning of your gut and to bring down inflammation, you need to consume brown rice, not more than one small bowl per day. Keep in mind portion size. I keep telling people portion size, they do not understand. Your majority of your calories should be coming from vegetables and fruits. Then this is very important, use this anyhow that you want to use: apple cider vinegar, turmeric, ginger, garlic, saffron, and take a magnesium supplement and a chromium supplement to accelerate the healing of insulin resistance. So if you follow this diet, you will see that you will not only improve insulin sensitivity, but you will remarkably decrease the chances of developing type 2 diabetes in near future. Thank you.